please rise for the Vice Chancellor's procession.
Restitution.
May I, at this point, respectfully invite the Registrar of the University, Mr. Ademola Obola, to introduce the Vice Chancellor and the Vice Chancellor's procession.
Please allow me to stand on the existing protocol and to distinguished academic community, University of Benin, the pride of this country and the pride of Africa. Let's give University a round of applause. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, this academic community is led by a distinguished woman of excellence within and outside this country. The Vice Chancellor of this university, though ably represented here because of other pressing engagements of the Vice Chancellor, it is my honor and privilege to present to Ross and of others. As you are aware, since she assumed duty as the second woman Vice Chancellor of this university, she has worked tirelessly to transform this university, and she is attracting attention both nationally and internationally to ensure that this university is put on the pedestal of excellence. And so today, she has requested one of the able lieutenants to stand for her, and of course, this is an academic exercise. The Deputy Vice Chancellor Academic is the one standing in for her, and that is our own very distinguished Professor David Nosekari Izeko, the Deputy Vice Chancellor Academic, as acting Vice Chancellor of this occasion. Of course, we have a woman giving us lecture today. Some weeks ago, I said women are taking over everywhere, and today, we have another woman also supporting the Deputy Vice Chancellor Academic to carry out the assignment of the Vice Chancellor at this occasion. It is my honor and privilege to introduce and present to Ross the Deputy Vice Chancellor at the House. We have the third leg of our decision in terms of the Deputy Vice Chancellorship. The Deputy Vice Chancellor of our Ekenwa campus, Professor John Ogene, is also very much here with us. We have the representative of the Bursa. The Bursa is very much busy now in Abuja. He's duly represented here by another very distinguished accountant of note, Dr. Dominic Eche. We have the custodian of our books and publications, and the scholar as well, the USC librarian, Dr. Luke Obasui. Today we are privileged to also have in our midst the provost of our College of Medical Sciences and a host of other deans and distinguished scholars in our midst here today. The provost is very much here with us today. And as the provost of our College of Medical Sciences, Professor E. Obiasu, is very much here with us. We have the dean of our postgraduate school also. He has his representative, and in due time I will let you know. But very much here, the leader of all the students in terms of leadership and administration here, the dean of student affairs, who will not be sleeping any time of the day, any time the students can call them for anything. So, Professor P.O. Ibinadu, the host dean, in case you are not properly served today, please hold on to him. He has promised to satisfy everybody here today because the inaugural lecturer is very dear to him. That's the host dean, the dean of Faculty of Physical Sciences, Professor F.E. Sagede. We have with us the Dean of Faculty of Arts, one of the tallest in the procession today, Professor A.S. School of Basic Medical Sciences, Professor F.O. Agoreyo, is also very much here with us. We have with us also the Dean of School of Dentistry, Chancellor, who has to be a specialist. Yamu is also very much here with us. So that I'm not fined by the Vice Chancellor. Has put in many legacies there. Professor John Akobi is also very much here with us. We have the Dean Faculty of Environmental Sciences, Professor P.S. Ogedengbe, is also here with us. We have the entourage as well, another woman of excellence in academic, and that's the Dean Faculty of Law, Professor V. Oaipo Kaibo, is also very much here with us. We have two of a kind. First, the Dean Faculty of Life Sciences. We have with us the Dean Faculty of Management Sciences, Professor E.L. Dabo, is also here with us. Representing the Dean School of Medicine is Dr. Mrs. E.R. Madu Bukwabo, is also very much here with us. Two of our directors very much here with us. Starting with the director of CRPU, that's our center for, ICT units, Professor David Obeifun, is also here with us. We have another smiling face, in the person of the director of gender studies, Professor Mrs. EU, and those someone, is also here. Yes. We have with us another very prominent director, a woman of academic excellence too, trying to support the inaugural lecturer of today. We have with us the director of students, guidance and counseling, Professor Mrs. V.E.I. Audu. We have the director of Center for Educational Technology, Professor H. Oek Hena. We have the director of the Fund Center of Excellence, who happens to be my very wonderful and great friend. He's a friend of the registrar, and is one of the tallest in the hierarchy of our procession. And that's the Professor O.J. Abolaga. Don't mind him, he's not explicitly seen in some part, but he's very much here. And he stood up. Let's give him a round of applause again, as soon as I call their names. We have another woman supporting the inaugural lecturer today, and that's the director of Central Research Laboratory, Professor Mrs. Ikoria. She's very much there. And then also we have the acting director of Institute of Child Health, Dr. D. Nwaneri. Education, Dr. Mrs. I.F. Iyamu. We have with us on the list the director of our institute at Dekewa Campus, the acting director of IPAES, Dr. Igo Ogaton. And today's lecturer is to be duly recognized, and the citation will be presented. She's in the area of software and so on. Thank God she's not so much in the era of hardware. Because the PRO said that women describe the area as very rare area. But thank God that the men will still have to hold us long. Professor David Zeko will present the inaugural lecture. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, as you have been informed, the Vice Chancellor of our great university is presently not available due to some other official engagements, but I'm here to represent her. I will read her address. The principal officers of the University of Benin, members of Senate, Provost College of Medical Research, Spiritual and Temporal, staff and students of our great University of Benin, gentlemen of the press, distinguished invited guests, ladies and gentlemen. It is with great pleasure that I welcome you all to the 247th in the inaugural lecture series of the University of Benin. Today's lecture is the 19th to be delivered in my tenure, as the Vice Chancellor of this university, and the fourth from the Department of Computer Science. I am glad to report that the second semester examinations have commenced in the various faculties, schools, and institutes. I want to use this to elicit free conduct of the second semester examinations. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my honor to introduce our lecturer for today. She is Professor Mrs. Francisca Avuwa Egbokala. The title of her lecture is The Most Neglected Peak in Software Development Projects, The Journey So Far Towards Reconciliation and Restitution. Professor Mrs. Francisca Avuwa Egbokala was born on 11th October 1966 to the family of Chief Solomon Edafion of blessed memory and Mrs. Joan Elo Edafion, both from Owelopo in Isoko North local government area of Delta State. She attended Ogu Primary School, Otibio, from 1973 to 1979. She had her secondary education at Anglican Girls Grammar School, Uweli, from 1979 to 1984. She obtained her GCE honorary level in 1984 and gained admission into the University of Benin in 1985, where she obtained her BSc degree in computer science, graduating with a second class honor upper division in 1989. She had her 1 year mandatory NYSC at Ogun State University, Agoiwo, as a programmer in Sigma Technical Agencies, Port Harcourt. Professor Mrs. Egbokala joined the services of the University of Benin as a graduate assistant in the Department of Computer Science in June 1994 to become the first female lecturer in the department. She obtained her master's degree in computer science from the University of Benin in 1997, and this was immediately followed by her PhD degree in computer science from the same University of Benin in 2007. She rose through the rank to the position of full professor in 2014. Her area of research interest is software engineering and information technology, with particularly the Kigali Institute of Technology, Kigali, Rwanda, from May to November 2005. She has held several academic and administrative positions in the university and outside the university, including acting head, Department of Computer Science, between 2014 to 2015, departmental post 2000 to 2009, member faculty of science, student disciplinary committee 2002 to 2003. She has also served as member faculty of physical sciences research publication committee between 2005 and 2006, and member dress code committee of faculty of physical sciences 2007 to 2008, member staff student relations committee 2007 to 2008, and also member Automatic Clinic Management Committee Board 2007 to 2011. She has also served as Faculty of Physical Science representative to Faculty of Education between 2007 to 2011. In 2010-2011, she was the representative Board of Gender Study. She has also served as a resource person in several NUC accreditation and resource verification teams, and as external examiner with her sector to several universities. She is a reviewer of several journals and conferences, and has presented papers in several national and international conferences. She has over 50 publications in learning society journals and conference proceedings. She has supervised several undergraduate projects, including 19 MSCs and 3 PhDs in computer science. She is a Microsoft certified professional as Organization of Women in Science for the Developing World and the Society for Research and Analysis. Professor Mrs. She is also Professor Ms. Ohio Egbokala, and their union is blessed to report to you. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my honor to invite Professor Mrs. Francisca Avuwa Egbokala, Professor of Software Engineering and Information Technology, to deliver her inaugural lecture.
Yeah, waiting in Salami. It will be presented by the Deputy Vice Chancellor, Academic Professor David Zeko, the Vice Chancellor, Administration, the Deputy Vice Chancellor, Kewan Campus, the Registrar of our great university, Boxa, the University of Benin, the Liberian University of Benin, Council, Provost, Dean, Professors and members of Senate of our great university, academic, great students. Thank you. Gentlemen of the press, ladies and gentlemen, I welcome you to the 147th inaugural lecture of the University of Benin. This is the fourth inaugural lecture from the Department of Computer Science. The title of today's inaugural lecture is The Most Neglected P. Vice Chancellor, it may interest you to know that a lot of people have tried to change the topic for me. Some of them said the missing P in software development projects. The P is not missing, it's neglected. So as we go on, we'll know which P is most neglected. In the early days of software engineering, there was what was termed the software process models for the improvement of the software process. Software process improvement models were later developed also to improve the software development process. Computer-aided software engineering tools, and also to improve the quality of the final product. But the crisis still loomed. High rates of failures are Vice Chancellor. Every software development project which utilizes three P's. Because software engineering is a complex process. It involves interaction between tools, processes, and people. Most software process models and software process improvement models focus on improving the software development process and the final product. But the P, which is most neglected, is the people of software development. Madam Vice Chancellor, software development is people-centric and depends highly on interactions between various processes and people. The biggest challenge faced by the software industry stems from a gross neglect of the people. Improvement plans and initiatives cannot be executed without people. Madam Vice Chancellor, people initiate software development projects. We call them the users. People manage the process of software knowledge, which is initially tacit, to quality software products. We call these people the developers. The task at hand this evening, therefore, is to discuss my research journey so far towards reconciliation and restitution in software development projects. Madam Vice Chancellor, the best definition of restitution I have seen is in Luke 19:8, where Zacchaeus stood and said unto the Lord, "Behold, Lord, the half of my goods I give to the poor, and if I have taken anything from any man by false accusation, I restore him fourfold." The software process is a set of other tasks, activities, and constraints that interact together to produce a useful product, which is called a software system. It describes the developmental strategies that encompass the process, methods, and tools used for software that describes the phases of software development. Software process improvement denotes changes implemented to software process that bring about positive project outcomes. Most software project improvement models are based on maturity models.
The sample of the software process improvement model is the capability maturity model by the Software Engineering Institute. It has 5 main maturity levels. My journey as a vice chancellor actually started with a framework by Chiemeke et al. 2005 that proposed the people task system framework for the classification of elements involved in the development and use of information technology systems. It was based on set theory. Then we showed the interaction and the union between various components used for information system development. It was a theoretical framework, and it had been neglected for so long. The tasks are the various activities and processes that need to interact. Then the systems are the systems and subsystems that interact together to produce the final system, which is called a software product. In that study, it was recommended that further studies be carried out in a developing country context and in a more practical environment to validate and extend that framework. Hence, Onibere and Egbokari, 2007, studied Nigerian software development organizations, and also to identify the people, because our focus was actually on the most neglected P. So we wanted to identify the people in software development projects and the tasks performed by these people. We also wanted to identify any possible factors that needed further improvement. We gathered data using a research questionnaire, and we assigned 1 to every key practice that was present and 0 to a key practice that was not satisfied. And we also put a past threshold as 80% of the key practices for each maturity level. If it is passed, then that maturity level is attained. Otherwise, it is failed. The findings showed that 70% of the organizations studied were at maturity level 1. This shows that software development organizations do not adopt standard methodologies and key practices. We also discovered that process, Madam Vice Chancellor, software project managers, as we observe, isolate developers from users during software requirements definition. Requirements definition is one of the most critical stages of software development. When users are isolated at the beginning due to lack of motivation, there was lack of proper documentation of software process activities. And also we discovered that there was slow response to technology, resulting from the unwillingness of software development organizations to invest in current tools and technologies. Madam Vice Chancellor, in Ephesians 4:11 we are told, and he gave some apostles, and some prophets, and some evangelists, and some pastors, and some teachers, roles as specific responsibility to carry out. So also, it should be in software development projects. But our findings showed that roles were usurped. User developer interactions, where we define specific roles for every stakeholder in a software development project. This was our first case of prostitution, Madam Vice Chancellor. Software developer needs to interact with the user. User and the software developer interact several times until the software requirements are defined. These requirements are then taken to the software project manager, who calls for a requirements negotiation meeting. During requirements negotiation, the software project manager should be present. The user or a user representative should be in that meeting, and also software developers should be there. So apart from restitution, this framework was also for reconciliation. During implementation of software systems, the software project manager is supposed to receive project information from the developer. The developer interacts with the user. The user is supposed to be the user interface designer. He tells the developer where to place specific objects. If there are any components that are not properly items are supposed to be identified by the user and also told the software developer, who returns such information to the software project manager. And if there is a need to alter the software project plan and still remain within budget, it is done. Madam Vice Chancellor, successful project outcome is a shared responsibility that requires commitment from the software project manager and the software developer. The burden, Madam Vice Chancellor, is more on the software developer. The software developer acts as a mediator between the user and the software project manager. See him in the middle. He is the one that takes project information to the software project manager. He's the one that gets the user's requirements and tries to translate them into code. Some of these requirements are usually tacit. They are difficult to, but we discover from schedules and costs rather than motivating software developers. Hence, there was low productivity and high developer mobility, resulting in abandoned projects. Hence, the Bokari and Munibere 2010A studied factors that motivate software developers. We used a questionnaire and we used a homogeneous sample consisting of only software developers. The outcome of that study showed that there were 12 factors that could motivate software developers. And we realized, Madam Vice Chancellor, that these factors could be intrinsically determined within organizations. They are unique for each software organization, and they differ from one individual to another. So we proposed in a framework by Bokari and Munibere 2010B that without compromising software project standards and ethics, software project managers can interact with software developers both formally and informally using these motivation factors. The outcome can be used by the software project manager to assign tasks to software developers that will help them fulfill their own self-esteem goals. Madam Vice Chancellor, this was a process of restitution and reconciliation, and we believe that it will reduce the high mobility of software developers. Chiemeke and Ebokari 2013 adapted the Ebokari and Munibere 2010 model to determine the causes of low developer productivity. A case study approach was adopted and a brainstorming session was held with software developers. It was discovered that these developers had low developers were sent to conferences, both national and international conferences, to upgrade and revitalize them. Developers were rejuvenated and they were given some code to write to implement certain user services that were not in the current system. This was a process of restitution because the software system that was given to them to use was not developed by them. Their inputs were not asked, and thus the system was difficult for them to use. There were certain user services that were not there. So they were rejuvenated and they were asked to develop certain user services which were now integrated into the main system to enable them to do their work properly. We discovered also that one of the causes of software project failures is lack of user involvement in software development projects. The Chaos 2012 report showed identified causes of lack of user involvement in software development projects. We discovered that users and developers, though they help towards solving the same problem, which is development of a quality software system, we discovered that while the users see, they think along the line of the domain of application, software developers think along the line of how to technically solve the user's problem. We discovered that there was a gap between users and software developers because the traditional problem of the inability of users to express their exact needs in a software system mental models. Hence, Azike and Bokari 2017B tried to develop a system or a model that resides in the minds of the users. So this was a cross-cultural research, Madam Vice Chancellor. We tried to work with psychologists because we wanted mental models are created in the memory of a user. And this memory, the part where the mental models are formulated, is called the primary memory, and it mixes up with other information. Hence, we have to formulate a strategy that directs a user's thoughts towards a solution along the same continuum. Hence, our problem was to try and think of how to capture users' mental models, which are formulated in the working memory of the user, the brain. It's a place that we call the working memory. If we could elicit these mental models before they mix with the content of primary memory, then we can elicit users' cognitive needs and help to obtain the first set of users that we refer to as G1. We exposed them to the experiment and we tried to interview them after 10 minutes. We used a prototype system. We used a stimulant, which was a prototype system, a software system. We exposed the users to the prototype, and after 10 minutes, we tried to interview them to a question based on what they saw as they were using the system. Then another set of users to verbalize as they were using the prototype. We used what we call think aloud protocol. We put a record in. Whatever they form in their minds were recorded. We discovered that this set of users gave us better cognitive requirements than the first set of users. A sample verbalization is shown above. One of the things we obtained from the recording was, this screen is too bright. No mouse, how do I make a choice? In other words, that user has never used a computer system that has a touchpad. He's used to use the system. Another user, a user 3, said, this box is too small. It did not bring out what I... Here is the dash-dash key on the keyboard. In other words, it was not used to wear something called the cognitive requirements, and we extended the software requirements definition to include functional, non-functional domain, and cognitive requirements. This was done by Bokare and Aziken 2017B. Categories and groups of users. And if requirements are elicited for only a subset of these users, then we will obtain incomplete requirements. Hence, situation in a multi-user environment. We discover that because there are diverse groups of users, we must find a way to elicit requirements from each of these users. Software users into formal users to profile these users and we obtain these computer systems. If they have any problems while using computer systems, they can easily solve these problems. We have the specialized users, these are executives, who use all the technical units to resolve these problems for them. Then we have the category of users that we refer to as the naive users. These users, they love to use computer systems, but they are not very used to computer systems. So when they encounter problems, they can abandon the work that they have to do and look for a solution to their problem. 30 users, they are not interested in using computers. When you go to elicit requirements from these categories of users, they will frustrate you. They will tell you you don't need computers. In another lecture, maybe when I'm doing my thesis or valedictory lecture, we'll talk about this class of users, because there are all the things we discovered during our research in 2008 was that there was lack of proper documentation of software process information. We discovered that developers, without any apology, can quit a software organization. And this is the greatest nightmare a software project manager. We tried to create structures to harvest the process of restitution by developers and the software project manager, and look, gather or harvest some of the knowledge they have and keeping it with the organization as what we call knowledge capital. Ove and Ibokari 2018, a software development organization. We organizations is what we call knowledge harvest. The organization can retain it. Knowledge elicit knowledge from this. We identify the experts for software development organizations, and we identified some knowledge entities as requirements definition, design and coding, implement knowledge. After harvesting it, we have to package actually tools that are used in artificial intelligence. They are used to visualize objects or entities. This is a sample concept map that we use to other vice chancellor. Most organizations do not understand the complexity of software development. When the software is wasting precious time, there are schedules to be met, and hence they do not motivate software developers. Other vice chancellor, programmers experience what we call blocks. When a programmer experiences a block, he cannot write the next line of code. It is therefore necessary for the programmer to find ways to resolve these blocks. We identified that there are several ways to resolve blocks. You can play games, you can walk around. Sometimes when we play games, it's not because we want to waste system resources, but it's because we want to recapture what next to do. We also discovered that coding, where an experienced developer is paired with a naive developer or a younger developer, for the best practices adopted with the expert developer, so that when the developer lives within projects, the project will not be abandoned or it will not fail. We also discovered, Madam Vice Chancellor, that ethnographic studies can be used to study the culture of an organization. The business rules can be understood. The domain experts can be identified, and a directory of domain experts in order to develop quality concept maps. Madam Vice Chancellor, visualization is just a design tool that we have. The knowledge harvesting is not complete if this knowledge codified the knowledge that was harvested. Concepts, relationships, and a set of axioms. The axioms actually define the logical relationships between entities. It is these logical relationships and these concepts that are actually programmed to produce. The process ontology is useless if it is not properly evaluated and tested and seen to be clear, accurate. 2020, try to evaluate the ontology that we created. We used a consistency tool in Protege to check the consistency of the ontology. And of course, since the software developers, the software project managers are going to use this ontology, and so that nobody will complain that it was not part of it, we try to reconcile this group of people by ensuring we did the evaluation. Madam Vice, this is how complex this design that must be implemented before for being part of this team. My maker, my pillar, my provider, my all and all, for making today. Professor Onokere Orayo, who employed me as a graduate assistant to this great university of blessed memory. He introduced us to the then Vice Chancellor, Professor Grace Alele Williams, and asked that he be given appointment as graduate assistant in the University of Benin. And Professor G.O. Oshodi, who announced my elevation, to also want to thank my honorable Vice Chancellor, ably represented by the Deputy Vice Chancellor Academy. I want to thank you, deep, very grateful. Now, I also want to thank the principal officers of the University of Benin. Thank you so much for being here for me. I want to thank FBU Osagede Babali. I want to thank my primary and secondary school student master, was my own father, late Chief S.A. Dakyoko. And my only former teacher in primary school was my mom, Mrs. Thank you so much, mommy. I love you. Thank you. Please share with me. I want to thank Mrs. Edelokujeni. Because of my small size, I hope I'm bigger now. She ensured that I was not bullied when I was in secondary school. I want to thank you, ma. I'm sure that somewhere listening to this inaugural lecture. I want to thank my father, my supervisor, who supervised all my degrees. He supervised me in BSc, MS, and PhD. Professor E.A. Oluwere. I appreciate you, sir. Thank you so much, sir. Mentor. Our best of friend, Amadi. Thank you so much. You are one great, happy family. I appreciate you all. I want to thank my wonderful sisters in the Department of Computer Science. My big sister, she is my Vice Chancellor in Delta State. Professor Mrs. S. C. Chemeke. Thank you so much, ma. I appreciate you, ma. I also want to thank my twin sister. They call her my sister. We call her Mominike because she is a mother to all our children. She was my MSc and PhD classmate. I also want to thank her husband, Mr. Obi Akukuma, who we call Ebio Mare, my friend, my sister, and my encourager. I say God bless you so much. The beautiful thing about Dr. Ebio Mare is that I was a co-supervisor. So, this is Ito Maekuno, That's how we started getting promotions. Thank you so much, my dear sir. I appreciate you. I appreciate all my senior colleagues from the faculty, SWD family, all WSD members from the best unit at Osa University, where I did my 1 year sabbatical leave. They made the place so beautiful for me. I enjoyed it for me. So my class of 1989, we all graduated from here together. I said thank you to you. 80 84 set, my classmates from secondary school. Some of them are here with me. God bless you. It's for more than for us in Jesus' name. I also want to thank my computer science of our senior colleagues. But yeah. Dr. Mrs. Azike is one of them. Dr. Obe is one of them. I co-supervise Dr. Mrs. Akoebio Mare with Professor Mrs. Chemeke. Thank you so much for making me so proud. They are all here today. God bless you. My MSc students are all for being here for me. I started work teaching me how to work hard. I want to appreciate all members of the Redeemed Christian Church of God, where I have been spiritually and physically of honoring side. Mr. Orie, that led the delegation for this other side of the podium, was my zonal pastor in the Upper Room family. Thank you so much. I thank the good women of all members of the Upper Room family. Thank you for being here for us. I want to thank the chaplain of All Saints Chapel, who is here for us today. Thank you so much, sir. And all the pastors that came with you from the All Saints Chapel. The wonderful women of All Saints, I want to appreciate you for being here for me. God bless you. I thank you. Really a great family. Our leader, Dicky and Mrs. Odogu, I want to thank you because I know you are here for us. You are here for us. Thank you so much for being so wonderful. I want to recognize the presence of our former registrar, Mrs. O.A. Oshodi. She came here just for me. Thank you so much, ma'am. I appreciate you, ma'am. And all the wonderful moments that have influenced my life positively. I want to thank my special family, Professor Azuo. I want to thank my Bonjo, who is here to represent my Gara family. Thank you so much for being here. I want to thank the former secretary that came with you. Thank you so much for being here for me. I appreciate you. Thank you so much. Delta State is represented here today. Thank you so, so much. I want to thank my wonderful neighbors who takes care of all my typing jobs. He's always there for me. I call him anytime and he answers. God bless you so much. I want to thank my late uncle, Israel of Bodjok, blessed me much, man. I want to thank my big auntie, the daughter of Zion. God bless this week. You are here. God bless you. I want to thank Dr. Matilda, who is here also with me, Ore Rata. Thank you for representing the ADGS 84 class. The academics are here. Thank you so much. To my baby, to my darling baby, Ore Vanessa Tova, I say I love you. Thank you so much. I want to appreciate my parents, Chief S.A. Edafiogo, blessed memory, and Mrs. Joan Eno Edafiogo. She's sitting here for coming this evening. I want to thank my parents and Reverend Mrs. Margaret Eboka. They are all here. I want to thank L.B. and Julian Meria. They are unable to come. I want to thank Mr. and Mrs. Theophilus Edafiogo, Fred Edafiogo, and Lee, not able to come, but I know they are watching online. They are wonderful. Who is a Major General Edafiogo? I want to thank Professor Blessing Ibinejo and his beautiful wife, Fanny. I want to thank Professor Boma Athanasios and his beautiful wife, Philo. I want to thank Franklin Edafiogo. Franklin is the Major also in the Nigerian Army. The wife just gave birth to a baby yesterday, so they are not able to come. My in-laws and their spouses, they are here. I want to thank Professor Francis Ebokari from the University of Ibadan and his beautiful wife, Dr. Yinka Ebokari. She is here. I want to thank Dr. Chris Ebokari and his beautiful wife, Dr. Stephanie Oware. I want to thank Dr. Christel and Dr. Chinyere Oware. I want to thank Austin and Jessab Oware, Jude Oware, Emmanuel and Rio Oware, Osase and Joy Oware. I say, who are the best? I want to thank my husband, the love of my life. In his lesson, Omra, all cherished. For this distinguished audience this evening, you are all wonderful. God bless you and take you safely back.
My duty, I'm the chairman of the Inaugural Lectures Committee. As you have all well noticed, the inaugural lecturer did not conclude and she did not give any recommendation. Or rather, she spent so much time doing acknowledgement, keep to the time. Let us keep to the time. Thank you. The inaugural lecturer of today has done justice to her inaugural lecture that is titled The Most Neglected Key in Software Development Projects, The Journey So Far Towards Reconciliation, namely process, people over the last years, towards improving the process and the products, thereby neglecting the people. The lecturer research work emphasizes efforts towards reconciliation of a lecturer, the role of the developer, as well as design framework that foster proper interaction among the people in software projects were well defined. The lecturer also explained the high developer mobility in software development organizations, as well as framework for developer motivation, using the problems of requirement elicitation in software development as the inability of users to express their needs, which are coming. These critical needs in software development could be like a requirement from only a subset system could be solved through profiling. As knowledge is a critical resource in software projects, therefore, knowledge harvesting could be used.
Acting Vice Chancellor as the chief whip, carrying the whip, is the Deputy Vice Chancellor Academic. So it's in his right. She's my sister Knight, Professor Stella Chiemeke. Welcome her. Welcome the immediate Deputy Vice Chancellor of Computing, Federal University of Technology, Sir Egafuna. Welcome the immediate past Substantive Registrar, University of Benin, O.A. Oshogin, Mrs. Welcome Mr. Mike Omoe Berale. Welcome, sir. We welcome Professor Yuka. Welcome, sir. We welcome the Chairman, Uniben Alumni Association, Imoni Kebe, you are most welcome. We also welcome Professor P.R.O. Adobame. Welcome Professor Henrietta Ogbo. We also welcome Chief John Odoma. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, that's how we conclude the 247th inaugural lecture. Almost sincerely for coming and for making it a success. Please rise now as we take the Uniben anthem and the second stanza of the national anthem.